Yes, I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Hallelujah. I'm glad to be in the place on this morning.
Yes.
I am glad to be among the living and not the dead. We thank God for allowing us to come here. Hallelujah. And I just thank God for the spirit of worship being in the house. Go ahead and stand to your feet, because we gotta cultivate the atmosphere. We have to cultivate the culture of this ministry. So, and I'm not one to really tell people to stand up, to tell people of God to stand up and lift their hands, because I believe that it's not a forced thing. It's not a thing where you should be instructed to do, but you feel the unction of the Holy Spirit that will lead and guide you to do so. But until we get to that point in that place, we're going to have to retrain the people of God here in this ministry, that as you come through the doors, you come in with a spirit of expectation, with your hands lifted, and being a part of the prayer that's going forward. So from this day forward, we come in this house. We're going to be participators and not spectators. We're going to walk so that the atmosphere can be conducive and we can stir it up with our bodies, because sometimes we come in and we're heavy. Sometimes we come in and things are on our mind. So in order to get those things shaken off of us, we're going to have to move and tell Satan that he has to release us. Whatever that thing was that agitated or aggravated you this morning, it has to go. The irritant has to go. Whatever it was, the argument, the kids acting crazy, whatever it was, maybe you stayed up or late at night because you just didn't get enough sleep for whatever reason, or God woke you up because you was interceding for somebody else. When we set foot in the house of the Lord, we have to be on one accord, and that's the only way that we can truly, as one ministry, come together and move up to the next level as one ministry, because we don't want to leave anybody behind. We're going regardless, but we don't want to leave anybody behind. I don't want God to move without me. I don't want God to shift without me. I don't want God to go to the next dimension without me. I'm determined I'm going to be in the move of God, not in the move of man, but in the move of God. And we have to teach you. And then I'm going to tell you, because I'm a teacher by nature. If I have to teach you how to get in the presence of God, if I have to teach you how to provoke the presence of God, if I have to teach you, and then I'm going to see how to summon the king to step into the room. If I have to teach you how to allow the Shekinah glory to fill the house, if I got to teach, then I'll teach you. I'll go back to the basics, God. Oh, yeah, I'm going to seek it. But what I do know is we're not going to come and congregate Sunday after Wednesday and struggle in an atmosphere. Because what's on the leaders has to be what's on the house. What's on the leaders has to be what's on the house. And we are worshipers. We dwell in the secret place. Oh God, we command that Oh God, spirits to line up. We command God, the flesh to be subjective under your authority, God. We command this atmosphere, God, to house your glory, Father. We thank you, Lord. That every time we come together, God, it'll be a ricochet, God. It'll be a domino effect, God. We thank you, Lord, that it'll be explosive in the spirit. And your oil will just flow. Oh God, we thank you, Lord, that we don't need anybody to convict us. Oh God, but you said that your word washes us, God. You said that your word washes us through and through. Your word is a mirror, oh God, unto us. And we reflect back onto how good you've been unto us, God. How good you've been to us. How good you are. What a good Father we serve. Okay. And because of that, God, we give you glory. There are lies in the balance. There are lies in the balance. There are lies that are most seeking of Akaya that desire your touch, God. There are lies that's desiring your move. There are lies, God, that's desiring for another breath of air. There are people that's fighting, God. Who can ever see a Rotaya? To be where we are, to be where we are, to be where we are, to be in the position that we are. People that want to be here. There are people that desire to have another opportunity to lift their hands. people, God. Let the eyes be open.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Let the eyes be open, God. Pull back the scale so that we see what's really going on, God. We can really see what's going on in the natural and in the spirit, God. Oh, God, pull back the scales, God. We won't be bare bones, God. We won't be fair, God. Oh, God, we won't back up, God. Oh, God, we won't back up, God. Oh, God, we won't want us to stay out of the face down, God. I think you right now, God, are pulling off the mask and revealing hearts, God, so we can see what's really going on. We can see who's really connected, God. We can see who are our friends, God. We can see, God, those that are for us and those that are not for us, God. We can see the truth of the matter, God, and strengthen us. As you show and reveal, we'll be able to take it, God. And not talk about taking pressure, we'll be able to take it, God. And move forward in the things of you. Oh, God, I thank you, Lord, for that. I thank you for connecting, God, and reconnecting and disconnecting. Oh, God, I thank you for connecting, God, and reconnecting and also disconnecting in this season. I thank you, Lord. I never see for the higher. I thank you for the power that comes when we connect together and get on one accord, God. I thank you for the frequency, God. I thank you for the electric. Rivers that flow when you're connected to the power of source, which is you, God. I bind up overload. I bind up overload. I bind up overload. My fire. I suck it up. We fasted and we prayed, God, but we still went and refilled, God. I told you about God now. Being a place of emptiness or fatigue. But we're strengthened. In our members, we're strengthened, God. In our faith, we're strengthened, God. Even in our flesh. Supernaturally. Supernaturally. The people of God will not be worn out. We won't be worn out. But we'll be strengthened. We'll endure to the end. We're fighting a good fight of faith. And when we finish, we're going to finish strong. Oh, Rabesitoya. And I command everything that we put our hands to, that the spirit of completion will be upon it. That we won't pick it up and drop the ball. We won't pick it up and then drop it. But I thank you, God, that we'll run with it, God. And we'll complete every assignment that you have given us to start, God. You said you're the author and the finisher of our faith. So I say that we'll finish it. We're finishers. We're finishers in the spirit. We're finishers in the spirit. We're finishers in the spirit, God. Hey!
Yes,
you know about you, but it irritates me when I start something I haven't completed. He reminds me. You still have this to do, daughter. Thank you for balance, God. We'll be able to get it all done. With grace, God. We'll be able to get it all done. In fact, the world will look at us and say, how do you do what you do? And we'll say, let me tell you about it. Let me tell you about the one who's my source, who strengthens me. Let me tell you about the one who rejuvenates me and pours into me so that I can do what he has called me to do with grace and with excellence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for moving in this place. I feel a release. I feel a release. We thank you, God, for moving how you want to move, for coming the way you want to come, for showing up in this place. Oh, yes. We encourage you in the spirit.
Jesus.
Wobbling and trying to get to the other side of the world so that they can get into the pond too. I felt that, hold on, I'm coming, I'm trying to get there, but don't leave me. So I pray, and I know that whomever it was, they received what they needed. They made it to the pond.
Amen, Lord.
They made it to that place. They made it to the place where God dwells. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Are you excited this morning?
Yes.
I said, are you excited this morning?
Hallelujah.
And you're really excited to be. But you ought to be excited for God this morning. And if you're excited for God this morning, you ought to do better than that. You got Almighty. He didn't do so much for you. You ought to give God your best praise. You ought to give God your best offering this morning. Amen. I'm here to tell you that God, He is up to something. Amen. You know that God, He is still getting in the blessing business. He's still in the yet delivering business. And He is still yet in the breakthrough business. And that is what God is getting ready to do. He's getting ready to cause breakthroughs to happen all over this world. He's getting ready to cause deliverance world. You just need to get a heart of expectation and trust the Lord thy God and lean not to thy own understanding. I don't care how it looks. I don't care how you feel. I don't care what the enemy has said. But God is a God of turnaround. And God is getting ready to turn around something for you. I don't know about you today, but I know I need God to turn around some things in my life. And I know that God is about to step out and you get ready to show up on my behalf. You ought to give God the glory. Hallelujah. I know it looks like you've been waiting for too long. I know it looks like you've been standing. I know it looks like you've been fighting too long. But I want to let you know that your warfare and your fight has not been in vain. Your standing still has not been in vain. Because God is getting ready to show up for you in this season. He's getting ready to come in the portion of the air like you never came before. This is a season in your hour to trust and believe your God for the impossible to be done. Got to raise your expectation level. You got to change your perspective in how you view God. I don't serve no little bitty God.
That's right. Come on, Seth.
I don't serve a statue either. But I want to let you know something. I serve a real and a mighty God. I serve an excellent God. I just feel that some of you need to be ignited in your spirit. Some of you just need to be launched in the atmosphere. Your belief, your faith, release in the atmosphere. Because God, He still get moving. Listen, I haven't given up on God. I haven't stopped believing and trusting in God. And just as long as I got a faith to believe and have a hold on to the expectation, then God don't have to show up. Because you know what? He's going to honor my faith.
That's right.
I'm here to encourage you. You got a little hold on. Just an ounce of a little hold on. If you got an ounce of just a little teeth, then eat the ounce of hold on. That's that faith that's the size of the mustard seed. Then God going to honor that faith.
Come on.
He's going to honor it. Because if he honored that level of faith, the faith that's the size of a mustard seed, then he is honoring his word. I don't care how you feel this morning. It's about the God that we serve. It's not about how you feel. It's about the God that we serve. That God cares enough about his word. Listen. See, this ain't even my message. God cares enough about his word.
Jesus. Come on now. His word.
He don't care if you got the faith of the size of a mustard seed. He cared about his word. That he said, I hasten to perform my word.
That's
how much he cared about his word. It don't really have nothing to do with your mustard seed faith. That's how he feel about his word. He ain't coming to my shepherd. Sometimes we in faith, and then sometimes we out of faith. But guess what? When a word has been released over your life, the moment that you're even not in faith, listen to this, the moment that when you're not in faith, God will still perform his word, because the word is still hovering over your life. When you're in a moment of doubt, God will still perform this wants you to be in faith. He wants you to have faith. But listen, he honors our faith, but most of all, he backs his word up. He backs his word because he is his word. Maybe your word don't mean much to you sometimes to other folk, but I'm going to let you know God's word means everything to him because he's standing on his word because he is the word. Got nothing to do when you're in faith this moment and out of faith the next moment. I'm here to tell you, I'm glad God is the God that he is. Because there were some times when I believed for some stuff. And I didn't believe at other times that it was going to happen. But all of a sudden, things began to come together. But that was the moment when I was out of faith. That was the moment when I began to doubt his God of God. God, you ain't never doubted God's word. Because he came by his word.
Every single thing that concerns your life,
Because he's going to, what? He's going to perform his work because he's watching over it. He don't care where you are in your life. He don't even care what the devil has said concerning your life.
All right.
Because you know the word that he has passed on your life. Hey. The devil can't do anything against you that he don't give the devil permission to do. So you don't have to continue to worry about what the devil is doing. All you got to do is get your eyes focused on God. When you get your eyes focused on God, God will deliver and set you free. And he will give unto you the thing that would you say.
Stay the course. Stay true to the mission of God that's in your life. Listen,
I don't care if men and women don't stay true to you. You stay true to God. You trade God on a Sunday. Don't trade God. Don't trade God for the counterfeit. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all ought to shout.
Yes. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory, Lord God.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Listen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We didn't let things come in our life that have changed our appetite.
Oh, you better say that. Wow. Oh, God.
Thank you,
Jesus.
We can't receive manna from God because we have accepted too many other things that have changed our appetite.
That's not
what I'm saying. You got so unfamiliar with the manna, now you eat the scraps. Go back to the acquired taste. How you get back to the acquired taste? How you get back to when you receive the manna from God? Get back in God's presence. Get back in God's presence. Get back in God's word. I don't know, but I want the manna from God. I want the manna from God. Because when I get the manna from God, listen, it's going to be in season and out of season. When you receive the manna of God, listen, you know how you look in your refrigerator or you look in your pantry and what you want to eat ain't even in the refrigerator. It's not even in the pantry. But it got a taste for it. Thank you, Pastor D. Listen, but when you receive the manna of God, this is at this end. I don't care any time that you look in the refrigerator of your spirit. I don't care when you look in the pantry of your spirit. When you receive the manna from God, it's going to always be food for you to eat. In the public of Sunday, whenever you feel like you're hungry, refer back to the word of God. And the word of God is going to produce the fruit, the manna that you need for the hour in the season when you feel as though there is a family in your. Listen, if you're hungry, you need to ask God for this man. You need to ask God to feed me. You need to ask God, feed me till I hunger no more. Feed me until I thirst no more. I need you, God. I need whatever is of you, God. I don't need something that's fake and phony, but I need the real deal. And I know that my God, He is the real deal. He is exactly what I need for the season and for the times. Give him away. Hallelujah.
You alone deserve my
God that said what he wanted to say.
Trying to steal from the people of God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I said, I pray a blessing. I'm saying, blessing.
Right through!
I'm talking about the areas that you've been waiting on a long time. And not on Sikaya. Even the word that Pastor said earlier about don't give up on God. I'm talking about those things that you've been waiting to see God do for some years. God said, yes, the blessing is coming in those areas.
Yes, Lord.
Do it now.
It's coming in those areas. And that's just sevenfold just for you. That's not talking about your household. So seven times however many people in your household, that's how many blessings.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah, that's a lot of blessings. That's a lot of blessings.
Oh my God.
I don't know what you're gonna pick out a household like. I'm
rich.
It's 56. Blessings, I expect to come. In the Freeman household. It's a lot of blessings. And I command every one of them to come. I command every blessing that God promised to come in your life. Sevenfold. And all have to come in the way of money or materialistic
come on.
Things.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
However you need God to move, it's coming. It's coming. I got a word I want to release. I actually forgot about it. I meant to release it before. I believe it's going to really bless you. I had a dream. I'm a dreamer. And in my dream, I was pregnant. And I gave birth. But when I looked at that which I gave birth to, it wasn't a baby. It was a bag of money.
Come on.
It was a sack with gold coins in it. And in my dream, I began to laugh because I knew it wasn't a natural thing. And it tickled me in my dream. And I thought about how Sarah laughed. And then I heard God speak to me in my dream. He said,
"Oh, wow.
Birth wealth." That's what he spoke to me. And that's when I began to get an understanding and a revelation behind it. Because we're pregnant. That thing which we're pregnant with, it's going to bring wealth into our hands.
That's right.
Yeah. And that's what God was saying. It's going to bring wealth into our hands.
Glory.
So I want to speak to every person in here that not only will God bring a sevenfold blessing, but that thing that you're pregnant with, those gifts, those talents that's on the inside of your belly, they will produce wealth in your life. And they will be birthed in this season. They will be birthed in this season. There will be birth in this season. You will bring it forth in this season. All those that are pregnant with all of the gifts that God has blessed you with. He's going to bring money into your hands. I'm talking about every vision. Oh God, I don't see God. Every book, I don't see every song, every sermon, I don't see God. I'm talking about every mentorship program. I'm talking about every business. Every business idea. I'm talking about every design. Every picture and painting that God has placed in your belly. Oh,
hallelujah.
And even that practice. God is breathing afresh. I feel in my spirit that God just wanted to encourage his people on today. He wanted to encourage his sons and daughters on today. He wanted you to come to the brook and to drink again. Tell you something else God said to me this morning. I don't eat seafood, but God showed me fish. Like tilapia, I guess, if I had to say.
So those that eat fish, you may know how you take a lemon and you squeeze it on that fish, and when you bake it, you expect to taste what? The lemon juice. God says he's squeezing his anointing over his people. We are tilapia, y'all. He's squeezing his anointing like a sponge. And after we bake for a season, we shall come out tasting like lemons. There should be evidence that the Spirit of God is in our makeup. We shouldn't taste the tilapia and we taste barbecue. That's not evident that God's anointing, his Spirit has been endowed upon us. So what I'm saying is, when you leave from Kingdom Nation, there should be a taste and a flavor of what this house represents all over your life. And if I look back over our lives, the ministries that we have served in, I can see some of Pastor Dre's, his flavor on my life. And go even further back than that, I can see some flavor of Apostle Rita upon my life. And I can go back even further than that, I can see the Culvers, oh God, a part of my DNA, because I was a part of their ministry. And that those limits have been squeezed upon my life. So I hear God say that as the apostolic prophetic anointing that rests in this house, as the gift of prophecy flows in this house, it should be evident upon your life. Because he said he's squeezing what's on the head down upon the people of God. And as those 56 blessings that's springing up in our lives, those same anointings, those same blessings, they shall spring forth upon yours. We're not going to get strange fire back. But that which is on the house should be evident in your life as well. That's how you keep the acquired taste of what's in the house on your tongue, on your taste buds, because you're not eating at everybody's table.
Come on.
That's another message that's coming forth for the leaders. Why it's important to make sure that you're keeping sacred your ear gates and your heart and your eyes and your spirit. Because it will tamper with your anointing, it will tamper with what you release, it will tamper. To tamper with your flavor. And give off a foul stench. And you'll think you're right. What you're releasing is accurate, and it'll be so far off. I'll tell you. But I feel the presence of God in this place that I haven't felt in a while. And as the house continue to be corrected, that anointing is going to shift to where it needs to be. As we continue to teach on unity and pray in the direction of unity and love, watch God move in this house. Watch him move in this house. because I've seen great things happen in these past 2-3 weeks. I have seen a shift take place in this house like never before. I've seen God move in this house like never before. And it's all because the minds of the people are coming together in alignment so that God can move the way he desires to move. We can't bring in people if we're not where we're supposed to be. The lost are not going to come in fellowship with the lost. It's one thing about the unsaved, they can recognize a phony in a minute. I told my daughter on the way here, I said, this year, I feel like God is, he's given us 6 months to get it right. We still have people that are still playing games, not getting in place and in position. I want you to send your prayers up for the Walker family. Yes, they're Walkers. Prayers up for the Walker families. They brought their sister-in-law, Brother Lee's daughter. She needs a miracle. I'm just going to say that. She needs a miracle. And when I hear things like that, I get angry in my spirit when I see people still playing church. Because you have lives in the balance. You have lives in the balance. You have lives that we have to fight for. We have people that we have to not all see cover in the spirit. We have families that we have to undergird and not all love us and protect in prayer. And we have souls that we are accountable for. Ain't got time to play no games. I ain't never been a playful person, even as a child. We gotta mature, rise up, and do what God has called us to do. I know I'm sorry things took a turn from a place of worship to a place of cleaning the house. But I don't apologize for being led by the Spirit, by being led by what I'm hearing God say. So again, just pray for the family. Pray for that family. Pray for the family. And make sure that we're taking this serious. Our place in the kingdom serious. Because one thing God told us, he was sending us seasoned people. And as seasoned people, certain things shouldn't continue to trip us up. No, we're not perfect, but certain things shouldn't keep tripping us up. We gotta be mission focused. Mission focused. And the mission is to tear down the kingdom of Satan, the kingdom of darkness, and to win souls for Christ.
And also, let's keep Minister Taylor and Brother and his family lifted. So let's be watching this individual like never before. You know, let's heighten our prayer life and our intercession. Let's be intentional about that. One man's word of it. That I did hear, that I heard the Spirit of the Lord speak in my spirit, that he says, I'm disconnecting and separating and destroying this spirit of familiarity. Because he said, I like Pastor said, because he also said, because I want to cause a refreshment to come. I believe God moved in this way because the prophetic releases a refreshment in the atmosphere. So just remember that we're going to experience many moments like this. So you don't experience the staleness or even the spirit of familiarity that tries to set in the house. Oh, and trust me, here's the reason why God. Oh, it was a word. That was a timely word. That was the need that was in the house. But God took care of some other things as well as the spirit was moving. So I thank God because God is getting us ready. He's getting us ready for what he desires to take place. So he's a He is not going to allow certain things that has been allowed to continue. Hallelujah. And I don't have anything else to say. Yes, the Lord's doing it. Ain't my doing. Amen. Y'all can stand and get ready to dismiss. Because God has said what he wants to say. He has moved the way that he desired to move in the house. I'm just going to accept it for what it is. I'm going to receive. Amen. I'm going to eat what I need to eat of what God released this morning. And for me, that was all good. I didn't leave nothing on the table. I didn't leave nothing on the plate. I ate it all. But it was truly manna from heaven. I was wondering on Facebook that word that was released, that God just stop the robbery in progress. That was for so many people that was on Facebook. But that's all right. I hope they caught it in the spirit. But I hope you all caught it. Because God stopped the robbery in progress that the enemy was trying to initiate in the spirit realm. He stopped. Moment of God, come. Yes, you come.